Welcome to Mastering Solutions. In this problem, we'll be using conservation of momentum to find the final speed of the ejected water by the jellyfish. So let's quickly draw a little jellyfish here. Give us an idea of what's going on. All right, so we have our little jellyfish friend, and it says that the total mass of the jellyfish and the water together is equal to 3.2 grams. We, of course, need to change that into SI units. So for grams to kilograms, we can move the decimal place over 3. So 1, 2, 3 gives us 0.0032 kilograms. And they say that the mass of the water alone is equal to 1.3 grams, which of course is 0.0013 kilograms. Now, we aren't given the mass of the jellyfish directly, but obviously we can just subtract the mass of the water from the mass of the jellyfish and the water together. So the mass of the jelly will be 1.9 grams, which is equal to 0.0019 kilograms. And they want us to find the final speed of the water. And they tell us the velocity of the jellyfish is equal to 0.07 meters per second. So now conservation of momentum is going to be used because we know that the jellyfish and the water act on each other, but there is no outside forces acting on what we're identifying as this system here. So we know that momentum will also be conserved. So the momentum of the system is equal to the momentum of the jellyfish plus the momentum of the water, all equals zero because of no outside forces. So if we subtract both sides of the momentum of the jellyfish, we get the momentum of the water is equal to the negative momentum of the jellyfish. So let's rewrite those over here. So the mass times the velocity of the water is equal to the negative mass times the velocity of the jellyfish. We're trying to find the final velocity of the water, of course. So let's divide both sides of the equation by the mass of the water. Divide by the mass of the water. And if we come up here, now we have the final velocity of the water is equal to the negative mass of the jellyfish divided by the mass of the water, all multiplied by the velocity of the jellyfish. We've talked about this in other problems, but don't allow the algebra to confuse you here. It's the exact same thing if we were to write the negative mass of the jelly times the velocity of the jelly all over the mass of the water. And we could also say this was positive and this was negative. It's all going to be the same answer. So when we plug in our numbers, let's give us a little bit more room. We have the final velocity of the water is equal to a negative 0.0019 kilograms for the jellyfish divided by a 0.0013 kilograms for the water multiplied by a 0.07 meters per second. If we wanted to be a little bit more precise to help you understand the concept better, the way I drew the picture up here with a jellyfish is I drew it so that the jellyfish is going in the positive velocity direction and the water is going in the negative velocity direction. But like we were just talking about over here, it doesn't matter where we place the negative. So we could have written it this way. We could have written mass of the jelly divided by the mass of the water times the negative velocity. But the picture is helpful to help us conceptually understand that the answer should give us a negative velocity. So when we do everything, if we end up with positive, we may have done something incorrectly. So when we plug this in, we have a negative 0.0019 kilograms divided by 0.0013 kilograms. And we're multiplying that by 0.07 meters per second, which gives us a final velocity of the water of a negative 0.1 meters per second after the jellyfish ejects the water.